Welcome to Dynamic Foundry Group. Today we are going to see a video on charge calculation study for gray cast iron with late addition tips. So let us start with the presentation. First of all, we are going to see how to make charge calculation for gray cast iron. The content or material which includes for gray cast iron charge mix is pig iron, MS scrap, cast iron boring, runner riser, CI rejection, and CI scrap. So this is a standard format for making a charge calculation, where on my left hand side column you can see various materials like pig iron, MS scrap, boring, runner riser, rejection, CI scrap is noted, whereas in right hand side columns carbon, silicon and manganese content in the respective material is noted. This is basically a master sheet, and you can change this master as per your incoming specification of raw material like pig iron, MS scrap, boring and CI scrap. So you can change it as per your incoming inspection element wise. Now we have added the charge mix, that is the KGS, in the format. For example, here we have put up pig iron 100 kg, MS 125 kg, CI boring 100 kg, runner riser 100 kg, CI scrap 100 kg. So total charge will be 525 kg. So with 100 kg pig iron with 3.7% carbon inside pig iron, similarly boring 3.2% carbon in 100 kg, runner riser 3.3% carbon in 100 kg, CI scrap 3.35% carbon in 100 kg. Total carbon inside the given 525 kg charge mix is 13.6 kg. Similarly, silicon is 6.8 kg and manganese is 3 kg in the given charge of 525 kg. Now, we can calculate percentage of available carbon, silicon and manganese in given charge, that is 2.59%, 1.3% and 0.57%. So, at present, whatever 525 kg charge is there, in that charge, we have carbon of 2.59%, silicon of 1.3% and manganese of 0.57% available in the charge. Now, we have to add percentage required in the bath. We require 3.4% of carbon, 1.7% of silicon and 0.7% of manganese inside the bath composition, as a bath composition. So what we required is 17.9 kg of carbon. So 525 into 3.4% is 17.9 kg of carbon is required to get desired 3.4% of composition at bath. Similarly, 8.9 kg of silicon is required and 3.7 kg of manganese is required. Now we have to get difference, that is difference between required carbon and available carbon, required silicon and available silicon, required manganese and available manganese. So you can get difference as 4.3 kg of carbon is required to get desired 3.4% of carbon in bath. Similarly, 2.1 kg of silicon is required, whereas 0.7 kg of manganese is required. So if you add 4.3 kg of carbon, you have to get 3.4% of carbon in the bath. However, we all know the carbon, silicon, manganese and all these elements doesn't have 100% recovery. So we have to add the recovery factor. We know recovery factor of carbon is around 85%, silicon is 60%, manganese around 60%. So by putting this recovery factor, we can get addition to be done is carbon 5 kg, silicon 3.54 kg, manganese 1.13 kg as a to achieve our bath composition of 3.4% of carbon, 1.7% of silicon and 0.7% of manganese. So this is how we can do this charge calculation. You can change the charge mix, you can change the carbon, silicon and manganese content from your raw material, that is pig iron, MS and boring in the master. You can change the required percentage of carbon, silicon, manganese in the bath, you can change recovery percentage of material as per your standards or as per your specific company requirements, and you can get desired values. So this is an example I have shown for your understanding. You can make it as per your own company requirements. You can also add copper, chromium to get these values as well. Now we are going to see the second part, that is the lead addition. Or after all this charge calculation and adding all this material, many times we have to add or we have to fine tune the final bath composition or final composition as well before we tap the material. So it is called as a lead addition of alloys and scraps. So this lead addition has to be done perfectly to get desired composition for the or desired chemistry for the getting required properties. So this is very important to have a proper lead addition control in melt shop. Here I have given element recovery for lead addition, that is carbon 85%, ferrosilicon around 60%, ferromanganese around 60%, ferrochrome around 60%, and copper around 95%. So let us start with some of the examples how we can do this lead addition calculations. So let us start with first, that is 3.25% of carbon is available in the bath, whereas we need around 3.4% of carbon in the bath. So we have to increase carbon by 0.15% inside bath metal. We have around 550 kg metal available in the furnace. So to calculate addition of carbon, what we have to do is 550 into 3.25%, that is 17.875 kg of carbon is available inside our bath, whereas we require 3.4% of carbon, that is 550 into 3.4% is 18.7 kg. So the difference is 0.825 kg of carbon. So we have to add 0.825 kg of carbon to get this 3.4% of carbon. But we all know again that the recovery factor has to be added. So by adding recovery factor of 85%, we can get carbon addition to be done is around 0.97 kg, that is around 1 kg of carbon has to be added to get 3.4% of carbon from 3.25% of carbon in 550 kg of metal. Similarly, for silicon, we have 1.5% of silicon in the bath. We need 1.8% of silicon in the bath chemistry. The metal inside furnace is 550 kg. So to increase silicon by 0.3% in 550 kg, we have to calculate how much silicon has to be added. For that, 550 into 1.5% is 8.25 kg of silicon is available in the melt. Whereas 550 into 1.8%, that is 9.9 kg of silicon is required. So the difference is 1.65 kg. The recovery of silicon is, or ferrosilicon is 60%. So considering that 60% recovery, we have to add around 2.75 kg of ferrosilicon to get 1.8% of ferrosilicon in the bath chemistry. Similarly, we sometime need to reduce carbon and silicon. Here we are taking two examples. Example number one, where we have silicon 1.95% in the bath, whereas we required 1.8% in the bath. So we have to reduce silicon by 0.15%. The metal in the furnace is 500 kg. So to reduce this silicon, we have to add MS scrap. How to calculate this? 500 kg into 1.9%, that is 9.5 kg of silicon is in the melt. We need 1.8% of silicon in the bath. So 9.5 divided by 1.8 is 528 kg of metal. So 528 minus 500 is 28 kg of MS scrap has to be added to reduce ferrosilicon or silicon percentage from 1.9 to 1.8%. So 28 kg of MS scrap has to be added. We are going to see another, the second example, where we have carbon around 3.66% in the bath, whereas we require 3.4% of carbon in the bath. Metal inside the furnace is 500 kg. So to reduce carbon, we need to add MS scrap. To reduce carbon, we need to add MS scrap And how to calculate is 500 kg into 3.66%, that is 18.3 kg of carbon in the melt. We need 3.4% of carbon in the bath chemistry to get desired composition. So what we need to do is we have to divide this 18.3 kg of carbon, which is available, divided by 3.4% is equal to 538 kg of metal. We have 500 kg metal already in the furnace. So 538 minus 500 is 38 kg of Ms has to be added to reduce carbon from 3.66 to 3.4%. So this is how we can do these calculations. So this is critical lead addition calculations, as while adding Ms scrap, it will also dilute your carbon, silicon percentage, manganese percentage, copper percentage, chromium percentage, etc., which need to be make up again with the addition of ferrosilicon, ferromanganese, copper, or ferrochromium additions, which is difficult to do manually. And there are chances of missing some of the additions while doing this manual calculation. So here, app which I have made in Excel helps you and your shop floor melting supervisors to calculate all the values in one single click. This can be easily used on his mobile and on spot. By just putting bath values and input of desired chemistry, he can get all required additions. You have to add base or bath composition and required composition and update any recovery percentage if any changes are there. Here it works in two phases. In phase one, it shows addition after bath composition, mainly carbon, silicon, manganese, copper, chromium, and Ms scrap. Whereas in phase two, it represents further addition due to late addition of Ms or addition required due to dilution of addition of Ms due to dilution of carbon, silicon, manganese, copper, or chromium. So the last column is the sum of phase one, phase two additions, which will give you total required addition basis on the basis of all the calculation of phase one and phase two. That is the total addition required to get desired composition. So this is how this app looks like. We can see here example number one, where we have silicon 1.9% and we have to reduce it to 1.8%. Here you can see in phase two, you can see Ms scrap is addition of 28 kg required, which is same as what we have calculated in our example. Due to addition of 28 kg of Ms, you need to add ferromanganese 0.25 kg, ferrochrome 0.07 kg, and copper 0.03 kg. And that is why the phase one and phase two both are required to get required desired composition because of late addition of Ms. You can see another example where we have reduced carbon from 3.66% to 3.4%, and here you can see around 38 kg of Ms scrap was required. It is same showing in this app as well. Because of this 38 kg Ms scrap is added, to compensate the reduction in other element, you have to add another 1.15 kg of ferrosilicon, 0.47 kg of manganese, 0.13 kg of chromium in the melt to get desired composition of these elements. So this is how this late addition app helps you in getting overall addition just by one click. There are many such apps or software available in the market as well. You can choose any one of them which will help you. However, if you want this Excel sheet, kindly drop a message to me on my number 855-549-8234 to get this app or Excel sheet. I repeat, if you want this Excel sheet, kindly drop a message on my number 855-549-8234 to get this Excel sheet or Excel app for your use. Thank you very much. Have a nice time. Now we are going to see a small demo of this app directly. So you can see here a small demo where you can see this app is open in Excel. You can see here 550 kg. We can change this material or total material available in the metal. You can see here carbon is 3.5 kg, 3.5%, whereas required carbon is 3.35. So add required MS addition is 23 kg. Because of that, ferrosilicon, ferromanganese, ferrochrome need to be added, which is been shown here. We can change this figure and how the overall effect changes, you can able to see. Here you can see another example where 3.25% of carbon is in bath and we need 3.35 carbon. So you just get addition of carbon here. Copper requirement is also here because we need another 0.05 addition of carbon. If we change here copper percentage, the copper requirement will get vanished. Similarly, if you add here 3.7% of carbon is there and you need 3.35, then you have to add another 58 kg of MS. And to compensate that, you need to add ferrosilicon, ferromanganese, chromium, and copper. This is how this app will help you in getting the things done easily without any mistake by manual calculation. So you can use this app on your mobile as well. So this is from my side. Thank you very much for patient hearing and thank